So after learning adrenergic receptor classification, here we are going to see adrenergic receptor tissue location, that is distribution, responses they produce after stimulation, and mechanism by which they produce response. Alpha 1 receptors are mainly located in the vascular smooth muscle, radial muscle of the eye, prostate, urinary bladder, and anal tract. Responses they produce at all these sites is mainly contraction. So contraction of vascular smooth muscle cause vessels to constrict and cause rising blood pressure. Radial muscle contraction leads to dilation of pupil and cause mydriasis. When alpha 1 receptor in urinary and anal tract are stimulated, leads to urine and stool retention. Alpha 1 receptors are GQ protein coupled receptors. Activation of alpha 1 receptors activates GQ protein. GQ protein activation leads to activation of phospholipase C. Phospholipase C creates phosphatidyl inositol bisphosphate. Phosphatidyl inositol bisphosphate is further broken down into IP3, that is inositol triphosphate, and DAG, that is diacyl glycerol. IP3 opens the calcium ion channels. Calcium is released into the cell. This release of calcium into the cell leads to the responses. Now, what is the major location of alpha 2 receptors? They are mainly located in the presynaptic site of central nervous system. They are also located in pancreas. Activation of alpha 2 receptor in central nervous system reduces sympathetic flow by decreasing the release of norepinephrine in presynaptic site. Activation of alpha 2 receptor in pancreas decrease or inhibit the release of insulin from beta cells. Alpha 2 receptors are GI protein coupled receptor. Activation of GI protein inhibits adenylate cyclase, thus decreasing the production of cyclic AMP from ATP. Finally, there is decrease the activity of cyclic AMP dependent protein kinases, which cause inhibition or feedback. Now you can imagine what effect inhibition of norepinephrine release would have. Now beta 1 receptors are mostly postsynaptic, mainly located in the heart and kidney. Beta 1 receptors are GS protein coupled receptors, so they activate adenylate cyclase, increase the production of cyclic AMP, and finally activate cyclic AMP protein kinases. Therefore, it increases the speed of heartbeats, force of contraction, and speed of conduction. When beta 1 receptors in juxtaglomerular cell of the kidneys are stimulated, cause renin release. Release of renin stimulates the production of angiotensin II, which will cause vasoconstriction and retention of fluids. Now, beta 2 and beta 3 receptors are also GS protein coupled receptor. They act by activation of cyclic AMP. Now, beta 2 receptors are mainly located in bronchial smooth muscles, gastrointestinal tract, uterus, urinary bladder, vascular smooth muscle. At all these sites, activation of beta 2 receptor causes relaxation, and therefore beta 2 receptor agonists are very important bronchodilators. They also cause uterus to relax, so used in premature labor. Beta 3 receptors are present on fat cells. Activation causes lipolysis, that is again by cyclic AMP activation. Now we are going to see how epinephrine and norepinephrine binds to the receptor, adrenergic receptor. We know adrenergic receptors are G protein coupled receptors, which are 7 transmembrane domain receptor. So these are the domains, domain 5, domain 3 and domain 6 of adrenergic receptor. And this is our molecule, which could be a norepinephrine or epinephrine, catecholamine. So nitrogen of catecholamine, norepinephrine, epinephrine acquires positive charge after protonation at physiological pH. So it is involved in ionic interaction with aspartic acid in domain 3. Hydroxyl group on beta carbon of catecholamine is involved in hydrogen bond formation with the domain 6 amino acid residue, that is asparagine. While same domain is having amino acid residue phenylalanine, its phenyl group is involved with phenyl ring of catechol moiety of epinephrine or norepinephrine with van der Waals interaction or hydrophobic interaction. Hydroxyl group of catechol are very important, and they are involved in hydrogen bond formation with serine residues in the domain 5. So in all, norepinephrine, epinephrine or catecholamines utilize hydrogen bond formation, ionic bond formation and hydrophobic interaction to get bind to the adrenergic receptor. Here are the references. Thank you.